Well, Sweden's only gold medals still today have come in the kayaking events, and Jette Andersson has two of them, and her partner Olsen has the third as they get ready now for the K4. You know, like the marathon last Sunday for women, this event is brand new in the Olympics, and it's a big step, really, for the women's faction of kayaking. The Swedes will be paddling closest to us in lane 7. On the far side of the lane, closest to the crowd, which, by the way, is a record group today, over 10,000 of them strewn all along the lawns, colorful and a beautiful, calm, sunny day for them. They'll be closest to the U.S. team at the top of the screen, and I'm sure giving them a lot of support. The Norwegian team in lane 2, the Great Brits in lane 3, the Romanians, third in the World Championships last year, but they have two new people in their boat, and they could be an unknown factor. The West Germans in lane 5, potential medal winners. In lane 6, Canada, and in lane 7, the great Swedish team. The Swedes, though, JT, have been having some trouble with their K4. They have four great individual paddlers, but all together, not necessarily cohesive.
Diana, the K4 is such a difficult boat because just the smallest change in timing, in balance, in rhythm can throw it off. We have the start.
Well, like the 8s in rowing, the crowd find the 4s the most popular event. They like to see those whirling paddles and the faction of teamwork coming on down. Here's a great view from the side from our camera boat that scoots along, making no wake next to them. And these are the Swedish women in lane 7 here. You can see their boat. Fairly even race so far, but the stern of their boat, you can see moving out on the field already. They're just maybe a few meters ahead of the boat in the middle, the Romanians.
But a very great development here. We have the United States up in lane 1, who right now is in the third position. This is a superb start for them, Diana.
The U.S. boat, known as fairly slow starters, and we should mention right now, up at the very top of your screen, there are four women in that U.S. boat. The third woman back happens to be named Leslie Klein, and she happens to be J.T. Kearney's wife. All right, up in the lead again now, Romania in the light blue shirts, dead set on the screen, have taken over by a couple of meters over Sweden here. They know exactly where the other boats are. Their peripheral vision is good enough, but they don't turn heads because they've got to dig in there and work. It's only 500 meters. Excuse me. Go ahead.
This race is certainly divided into two packs. We have the race for the silver medal. The Swedes have now moved ahead of the Romanians. The Canadians are coming on very strong, stroked by Alexander Barre that we saw yesterday. And up in the top, Sheila Conover stroking the American boat. That's the race for the bronze medal.
Wow, look at this. The American boat at the top of your screen, and down here, the Canadians. Canadians finished in the K2 second yesterday, but that's a race, and the Romanians and the Swedes are right down to the finish also.
Something happened in the Swedish boat. As we look at the replay, something happened in the last 15 or 20 meters with a Swedish boat.
Well, we'll take a look at that in a minute, but the Romanians in the light blue here make up for a lot of lost paddling time. The Romanians have not done as well. They've made it into the finals, but have not done as well as they had hoped to in most of the other events. Sweden finishes second, and they'll settle for the silver, I'm sure, and the Canadians get another medal after having that silver yesterday in the K2. We're going to take another look at the finish now. Go ahead, JT.
We need to look at something happens. One of the Swedish paddlers, I think the stroke dropped her paddle, and this fell off from leading the race and dropped back to second place here.
The Romanians take it. They repeat their world champion performance, at least their first this time. Swedes down on the bottom of the lane are second. Right next to them, Canadians third, and the U.S. had a great race also in fourth.
So the Swedes have gotten badly out of stroke here. Someone has just completely lost the rhythm in the middle of the boat. The Swedes fall apart there in the last 20 meters and lost one place. They're still not together.
Oh my goodness, you're from the front view. It's totally out of sync. Outrageous. They're not going to like to see the films of that race, I'm sure. So the Romanians take the gold. They're going to be four of them with a gold hanging around their necks. The Swedes, even with bad sync, are second. And the Canadians take another medal for third.